I was at Lexington for, sorry. For 2 years. And, like, I had 90-minute class, like, every day. But at River Bluff, I have, like, 2 hours of ILT. It's so great.
Thinking back on Lexington,
which makes me sad, I'm sorry.
I can't do this anymore.
This whole grading for learning thing really just reminds me of Lexington. How we didn't have formatives. Just bringing back all those memories.
At Lexington, there were no windows. It was a cold, cold, empty place. Filled with nothing but walls. Now, see, there are places with windows. There's a sky. It's so beautiful. And now there's freedom. Freedom to soar.
It's so much better. There are windows everywhere. The light just gives me an idea that there's hope at River Bluff, and it's really helping me. It's done a lot to help me and others like me. So thank you, River Bluff.
It goes to
Jackson.
I've been here about 13 weeks now. The hallways are so big. Lexington's so small.
For 2 years, I suffered at Lexington High School. All the classes being so long. Out at River Bluff, I finally have an opportunity to shine, where I have the freedom to do whatever I need to do, whenever I need to do. Thank you, River Bluff.
And as Danny and Violet connected on that night, they remained one of the most noticeable couples at the high school. Sam got an A on his project, even though the movie was never finished. And Brett's still as dull as a plastic knife. In fact, he still hasn't had any luck with a girl. Now, I think that about sums it up for the teens of this story. I could tell you more, but there's really no point. Not much left. Well, there might be, but... You know what? I don't know.
Unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable.
And as God has struck the hour, day of judgment, God is calling. On the knees, the war pigs crawling, begging mercies for the sins. Satan laughing spreads his wings. Oh, Lord, yeah.
Wait. Stop. Hold on a second. Before I get into this insane debauchery of sparkly colors filled with emotion and parallel universes with wormholes and paradoxes, allow me to introduce who I am. My name is Dr. Stephen D. Varnish, and I am a certified botanist. If you don't know what that is, it means I love plants. I love to smell them, take in all their joy and wonder, and embrace them as my brothers.
Stephen has a little problem. In our industry, we call it the raging snout. Instead of studying the plants, he sniffs them.
Certain day that my sniffing had gone too far. It eventually led to an out-of-body experience.